get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Robert Donner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from the Young and the Restless, Melody Thomas, McLean Stevenson, and Marcia Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Renner.
Ready? Then let's all have a brisk round of applause for Marcy Bennett and Rip Ribble. Now, just to reacquaint ourselves with you, Marcy, would you lightly fill us in on the story of your life again, please?
I'm a cocktail waitress in Orange County, and I live in Huntington Beach.
A rich, full life, if I've ever seen it. All right. Rip, tell us about you.
I live in Fountain Valley and work in the city of Costa Mesa with the Leisure Services Department. And I have a wife and two children, a little boy and a little girl, and I like the game of golf.
All right, where are we? Are we at the last round of the last game? And since Rip is ahead, the rule says you have to go first.
I'll choose B, please.
All right. Bob, you lay out. Melody, you lay out.
The so rest of speak. You.
So to speak.
So to speak.
Right.
Not in the literal line.
Victor said.
Yeah.
My wife likes everything shiny. Not only does she polish my shoes, she polishes my blanks. Here we go. Victor said, my wife likes everything shiny. Not only does she polish my shoes, she polishes my blanks.
Oh, I would probably say underwear.
Underwear.
Oh, no.
Underwear. Polishes my shorts. I don't think the audience is too thrilled with that. I hope they're more thrilled with yours.
This is what Bob just threw away. Rip's children are called Torn and Tattered.
Torn Ribble and Tattered Ribble.
Well, I like it. I thought it was heaven. Well, no, I said balls, tennis balls.
Okay. All right.
Socks.
Socks, very good. Tennis balls and socks so far. Two good answers. All right. Not only does she polish my shoes, she polishes my blanks, McLean.
Okay, Ripper.
Rip!
I said feet.
He sure likes this show a lot, I tell you. All right.
He's having a wonderful time.
Yeah, Marcia. Marcia.
Gene.
Oh, Marcia.
Gene.
Marcia.
Feet.
You know Benny Hill did that old routine recently?
When was that?
John and Marcia on his TV show.
It's not that old.
It is that old.
It is old. Actually, I was just testing it.
What's the name of the guy who did it? Stan Freeberg did John and Marcia around 1950,
I would
say.
It's not that old.
Not that old, no.
It's not as old as some people.
Marcia.
Yes.
You need two to tie and three to win. Are you ready? Harvey said, this weather is really hot.
How hot is it?
I came home and found the blink swimming in my aquarium. Everybody plays. Here we go. Harvey said, this weather is really hot. I came home and found the blink swimming in my aquarium.
The dog.
The dog. Good. A little logic to that, isn't there?
Excellent logic. Would you believe that the dog pulled the children in with him?
Aha! Smart dog.
Yes.
Yeah.
No ding ding, huh?
No. Never liked those kids. What'd you say? Show's a
I
dog.
I love you saying logic. There's logic in that. 9 years we've been doing this show, and all of a sudden he's
logic.
Talking about logic.
Right.
There's logic in that. He cried, heavens, no. Listen, dear, the dog is nothing. The housekeeper.
Housekeeper, another good one. They're all good.
Has she finished?
Yes, she has.
Sure. One for Marcy.
Okay, America, show us your dogs.
I love Brett. She always keeps me from making a fool of myself. Maid.
Maid. That's all right. Maid is okay. McLean?
I rather enjoy just making a fool of myself on my own. Therefore, I said cats.
You got us to have another dog here to tie. Really hot weather. Came home, found the dog swimming in my aquarium.
Is this another one of those must matches?
Right.
With the pressure and all that?
Right.
That's aged me before my time. I'm only 19.
You getting an ulcer?
Oh, sorry.
I hope I don't have to slap her.
Right.
Dog A.
Oh. Nice score. 2-2. Game ends in a tie. We'll break the tie after this. All right. It's time to go to a tiebreaker. We've already eradicated the lights here and pushed the button, revealing one tie-breaking question for each. The one who matches the most celebrities will be the winner. Marcy, you go first.
I'll take B, please.
B. See how nice that was? The nurse said to the Hollywood doctor, "What are you doing with that ping pong paddle?" And the doctor said, "It's not a ping pong paddle. It's the tongue depressor I use on blank." It appears everyone is ready, Marcy. We come to you. The nurse said to the Hollywood doctor, "What are you doing with that ping pong paddle?" And the doctor said, "It's not a ping pong paddle. It's the tongue depressor I use on blank."
I use on loud women or big mouth?
Big mouth people.
Well, now don't be hateful.
We were thinking of something, someone more specific. What do you say, Bob?
Pick on her.
Well, I said Martha Ray.
Martha Ray. She's a big mouth person. Yes,
Brett. They called her the big mouth.
Right.
Did they not?
That's right.
Well, I did your favorite, Howard Cosell.
Oh, yes, terrific. He talks a lot.
Wonderful Martha Ray.
Martha Ray.
Oh, I love Martha Ray.
Tongue depressor. It's not a tongue. It's not a ping pong paddle. It's a tongue depressor I use on
Martha Ray.
Martha Ray.
You must be well. 70. Martha Ray.
Martha Ray. No one says King Kong. Wouldn't he have a big tongue?
Well, no, I didn't, Gene. Why don't you kill me?
Okay.
You just kill me. Why don't I just give up show business right. And leave town?
Why don't you?
Excuse me for not saying King Kong.
Say it. Just say it.
King Kong.
Okay. That's all I wanted.
It's all it takes to make him happy?
Right.
A man easily entertained. But that's another ugly story involving the Encino Motel, isn't it? In the meantime, in between time, ain't we got Howard Cosell?
Howard Cosell. All right.
You're on tonight, aren't you?
Again, you're in the driver's seat. The Undertaker said, "We just buried Fat Frida. She was so fat, the only way we'd get her into the coffin was to blank her." The Undertaker said,
"Okay, wait."
The Undertaker said, "We just buried Fat Frida. She was so fat, the only way we'd get her into the coffin was to blank her."
I say roller.
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 Just in case here, I'm going to get the other tiebreaker question ready. There it is.
Wise choice.
Okay, Bob.
Well, Gene, I'm not going to break up this rally. Grease.
Greaser. That's a good one.
No, the only, she was so fat, the only way they could get her in the coffin was to melt her down.
Yeah.
Slice her with a new exciting slicer by Sunbeam.
Cut her down to size. She was so fat, the only way we could get her in the coffin was to what her, Melody?
It's really disgusting, and I shouldn't have written this down.
Drain her.
I said drain her.
Drain her. Just get a little of the fat out of her. Slip her in there.
Yeah.
What do you say, McLean?
I just want to say, should this question appear offensive to any of you fat, dead people, it's all in fun. Let the air out of her.
Oh, you must... You must show me where that nozzle is sometime.
Oh, I like Marcia. That. I did like that. Well, in continuing the taste roll.
Right.
And to make you happy, Gene, have King Kong sit on her.
Yeah. Well, what do you say, folks?
That's funny, Marcia.
The tiebreaker didn't break the tie,
Let's
did it?
Let's do it again.
What are we going to do? Well, we're going to do a commercial. That's what we're going to do.
And here again, the star of our show, Gene Rayburn.
Gene? All right. Well, we figured out what we're going to do. And I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go to our little quickie tiebreaker here because we don't have time for the regular one. And I have one question. You'll write your responses to that, and then I'll canvass the stars for verbal responses. And when you hear your answer, let me know. Good luck to both of you. Blank all day. Blank all day.
This is a verbal response.
Right.
I got it.
Well, you don't have to put it to your little thing in the slot.
All right. When you're finished, put them in the slots there facing you, right? All right. Now, if you hear your answer, let me know. Bob, what do you say to this?
Roll around heaven all day, like clouds.
Roll around heaven all day?
Yeah.
Is that an excerpt from a poem or a song?
What?
Sure.
No. It is?
A song.
Old Man River or something?
No.
No.
Or not.
Up in the morning, down upon one of the day.
Sleep all day.
Sleep all day. Has anybody got that? Rip's got it. Come on down, Rip, you're the winner. Oh, my God. Work all day. Very good. Come on down. We have some gifts for you. We're going to send you a case of Whiplash and some black and blue marks. And thank you for being with us, Marcy Bennett, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. All right, another shot at the money here for you. We polled an audience, Rip, and we said write down your best answer to this. Genuine blank. Genuine blank. Marcia seems to have an answer. Do you want to call on her?
Marcia?
Why, thanks, Rip. What Brett Summers is, the genuine article.
The genuine article.
Two people like it.
Charles?
Genuine leather.
All right.
Melody?
Got one, Melody?
Oh, God, you would do it now.
Gold.
Genuine.
Gold.
Gold.
Gold. You just thought of that. Very
yes,
quick
just
mind.
Like that. Isn't it amazing?
Right. All right, so you have genuine gold, genuine leather, and genuine article. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
I think I'll take leather.
All right, sir.
I would.
He's into leather. Let's see if we got genuine leather under the $100 response. Genuine gold is there.
There you go, Melody.
The $250 response says, genuine risk, a wonderful racehorse. And the $500 response says, genuine leather. Very good risk. Atta boy. Now you got $500, means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But let's see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. Good luck to you. See if you can spin a double.
Every time.
All right,
oh,
Melody,
again.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Listen, she was very good last time she was in this position. She did it well. Stand on the blue dot there. Face me if you would, please. Good luck. Here it is. Blank chemicals. Blank chemicals. All right, your job is to match Melody. If you do that, you get $5,000. What do you say?
Nuclear.
Nuclear chemicals. Nuclear chemicals. All right. Let's find out if you do match Melody. What do you say?
I'm sorry. I don't want to prolong this. I said harsh.
Harsh chemicals. All right. Listen, he hasn't done badly, has he? He's got a total of $1,000. And we thank you very much for being here on Match Game. Thank you very much, Jeff. Now we'll bring in two new players here, Jerry Spence and Michael Silver. Welcome to both of you. Michael, let's find out about you.
I'm a flight attendant for a major international airline, and I live in Honolulu. And one of my biggest things I'm proud of is that I'm one of the few people who has learned Dutch as their second language.
You just learned that on your own, or do it in college, or?
No, I lived in Holland for 4 years.
Oh.
That'll do it.
That'll do it, right.
Lots of windmills and chocolate.
Right. Now, it's very close to German, isn't it?
That's right. Very close, like about 90 miles.
Yeah. Let's hear a little
Dutch. Did you ever, You know, this game is shown in Germany. I wonder if it's shown in Holland. It's called Schnickschnack over there.
I think that's in Germany.
It's in Germany, yeah.
I've seen it in England. It's called
Blankety
Blank. Blankety Blank, right.
Right. All right, Michael, welcome to you and good
Thank
luck
you.
To you. Have you got the clack here, or has she got the clack? Have you got the clack?
What's the clack?
A group of supporters in the audience who
no,
are yaying
got
and...
the clack.
Oh, he's got the clack.
Two silent partners.
Yeah, where is your clack? Raise your hand. I see. He brought the whole crew with him. He got everybody with an air controller there. All right, now let's find out about Jerry Spence.
Well, I'm a hairdresser in Irvine. And and I recently got married in Lake Tahoe to a guy I lived with for 5 years, and everything's going real smooth so far.
Good. How long have you been married?
A month.
A month?
Yeah. Yes.
All right. Well, you've had a long trial period. It would seem to me that it would be successful. Michael, you have a chance at A or B first.
I'll take B.
All right, sir. Sid said, sexual freedom has gone too far. Last night I went to the movies, and there was passion, excitement, and nudity. And that was just in the blank. Here we go, Mike. Sid said, sexual freedom has gone too far. Last night I went to the movies, and there was passion, excitement, and nudity, and that was just in the blank.
My favorite part, the cartoons.
In the cartoons. All right, what do you say, Bob?
Well, I said in the coming attractions.
The coming attractions. That's a good one. All right, Brad?
I said just in the newsreel.
In the newsreel.
We don't like that? Well, all right.
It's not bad.
I said in the lobby.
In the lobby. In the lobby. And I went to the movies, and there was passion, excitement, and nudity, and that was just in the what, Melody?
Smaller places are the coziest. In the box
office. In the box office. Uh-huh.
Of course, by the time it gets down here, it loses a lot of its impact. I said the lobby.
Yeah. It's a now challenge you're... to sit in that seat, McLean. It really is.
Ah, I know that.
That seat?
Yeah.
What about this seat?
Oh, that's more of a challenge.
That's more of a challenge.
Yeah.
And more of a letdown when you say lobby.
All right. Lobby seems to have been the answer there, Michael. All right, Jerry Spence. Archie said.
Oh, I loved Archie.
When I was born, my parents kept me in a tin can. For years, I thought I was a blank.
No, you're just the fastest.
Archie said, when I was born, my parents kept me in a tin can. For years, I thought I was a blank.
A peanut.
A peanut. Another tiebreaker coming up. All right, Bob.
Well, I said a piece of silly putty.
A piece of silly putty? They come in tin cans, don't they?
Yes, they do come in tin cans.
All right.
Oh,
the little plastic
the
eggs.
Plastic eggs.
That's
yeah.
right. I haven't bought any silly putty ever in my whole life, and that's
sure?
the way it's going to be. All right?
Oh, didn't you ever buy any silly putty for Lynn when she was a
no,
little girl?
No.
Oh, golly gee whizzikers, criminy Dutch. I didn't say anything that was said before this. I said a container of baked beans. Or, pardon me, a container of Boston baked beans.
Right.
My memory's not too good this
right,
week.
Right, that's true.
A tuna fish.
A tuna. Charlie the tuna in his tin can. Of course, Charles. My parents kept me in a tin can for years. I thought I was a... what?
Now, I think this is a good answer, but usually the upper row knows what's going on, but I...
That's good.
I said sardines.
Sardines. Good. Are you yeeing her because, No, I know.
Well, we'll soon know because, I said sardine, too. Yeah, it's the sweater.
That's right.
In fact, some of it is on your jacket.
Really? Are you shedding? That's real wool,
it
is it?
It is, yes, I'm
Feel
shedding.
Feel that. That's
Hope
real wool.
No, it's okay.
What?
It's
oh, all right.
Sorry, Gene.
Oh, too bad. What do you say, Marcia?
I say sardine, and do you like my sweater?
Yeah. All right. As round one, no score for either of our players. We'll start round two in a moment or so, but right now we have this for you. Gene Rabiner, join us next time for the Match Game. Thank you all.
Today's contestants will also receive a Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner with pure wheat germ oil and honey for fresh-smelling hair with super shine, super body. And Flavor Ice, America's favorite quick-freeze fruit-flavored bars. 24 giant bars in the package, assorted delicious flavors. Flavor Ice, the giant cooler. Easy Caulker, foam caulker, and easy insulator for wider gaps. No gun to mess with either can, easy caulker, easy insulator. Raid crack and crevice spray. Unique extension wand sprays hard-to-reach places to kill crawling bugs. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Woodson, Bill Taubman production. The program was edited for broadcast.